Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dr. Karen Mella, Chair of the Music Department at Brock University, and I'd like to start by reading the land acknowledgement. The Brock University acknowledges the land on which we gather is the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe peoples, many of whom continue to live and work here today. This territory is covered by the Upper Canada Treaties and is within the land protected by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Agreement. Today, this gathering place is home to many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples, and acknowledging reminds us that our great standard of living is directly related to the resources and friendship of Indigenous people. So welcome to tonight's simultaneously live in person and live streamed Wind Ensemble event. Welcome. Pretty exciting to have this happening. I have my phone here to remind you of a couple of things, First of all, it is being live streamed, as I mentioned. So if you're looking for the recording of this performance, you will be able to find it after the fact. Where to find it? On YouTube at the Marilyn I. Walker School of Fine and Performing Arts page, M-I-W-S-F-P-A. Go to YouTube, look up Brock Marilyn Walker, you'll find it. And then click videos and poke around, you'll see it, it'll be there. So because of that, no one should need their phones. So please take out your phones, please silence them, even if you think they're not silent or they are silenced, please check. And I'm mentioning this because the other night in the middle of a slow movement in the string concert, someone's phone went off. Please, please, please silence your phones and put them away. Masks on, phones off. And what else did I need to tell you? Well, we are so thankful to have all the hard work of our students and community members here, and of course their conductor, Zoltan Kalman. And we have many other people we need to thank, but I'll just leave it general. The team at the Marilyn I. Walker School, especially in the publicity office, getting everything together from the administrative side of things, it really takes a lot to put these things together. And especially on the ground here at the First Ontario Performing Arts Centre, these people are top-notch, the most professional, wonderful people. And seriously, they work so hard behind the scenes, you don't even know. So I would like to thank our friends at the First Ontario. If you're craving more performances, we will be resuming after our Christmas break. In January, on January the 21st, Friday, the Walker String Quartet will be performing in the recital hall. In-person status to be determined. I still have to set that up. So now the classes are done, I might have time to do that. And starting February 1st, Tuesday, we will resume our RBC Foundation Music at Noon concert series in the recital hall as well. So stay tuned for information on that. Where to look, brocku.ca/music under performances for all the most up-to-date information. So you didn't come to hear me talk. I will step back now. Please welcome our Brock University Wind Ensemble and their conductor, Zoltan Kalman.
Thank you. Good evening, and welcome back. It's great to see all your smiling faces, well, hopefully under the masks. My name is Ethan, and I'll be your host tonight as we celebrate the Brock Wind Ensemble's return to live music. We have a great set list lined up for you tonight, handpicked by the maestro himself, the one, the only, Zoltan! Kicking things off, we have a fun tune composed by John Wasson. Remember going to the circus as a kid? Seeing all the animals and watching all the shows? Well, in this piece of music, the band goes off the rails. Well, not literally. As they take you for a wild and wacky ride. Everybody to your seats. It is time for the curtain call. That was a great way to kick off our show. Our next piece is composed by Philip Sparke in 1986. This piece will whisk you away on a train ride you will never forget. This piece was requested by the Tokyo Kosei Wind Orchestra, which is known to be one of the top wind ensembles in the world. Now, prepare your ticket, and it's all aboard as a journey on the Orient Express begins.
Thank you.
Such an amazing piece, and congratulations to Carlo on an amazing saxophone solo. Our next selection in tonight's setlist is an operatic piece written by 18th century composer Richard Wagner. This piece comes at the end of the second act of his 1848 opera, Lohengrin, in which Elsa, no, not the one from Frozen, is about to be wed to Lohengrin, who is a knight of the Holy Grail. No, he's not one of the knights from the Monty Python film, but this piece has the word romance flowing through it. We would also like to welcome our pianist Emilio to the stage, as he will be playing the piano accompaniment in this song. Please enjoy Elsa's procession to the cathedral.
Before this number, I just would like to say a few words to you guys. Good evening and welcome to our show, and thank you so much for coming out and to support us. This is a big moment for us, obviously. The last time we performed here in Partridge Hall was 2 years ago. And last year, just 2 weeks before the last performance that we were supposed to play, COVID hit and the show got canceled. In-person and performing arts in general have come to a complete halt all over the world, and we have spent an entire school year online through Zoom sessions and recorded individual parts for virtual videos. Then in September, we were able to resume in-person rehearsals with limited number of players due to safety protocols and started to work on an ambitious repertoire that you're able to hear while you've been listening to it already. In non-COVID times, we would have anywhere between 50, 60 players on stage. However, we are only allowed to have 30 players this year, which means that we have one player per part. It also means that every little mistake is magnified and can be noticed, as the players have greater responsibility. I can tell you that this group of players has answered the challenge with flying colors, and we are absolutely thrilled to be able to perform for a live audience once again. Our program features an amazing selection of masterworks of the past and present, as well as easy listening for your nonstop entertainment. These fine musicians have worked extremely hard in the past 3 months, and we are grateful for the opportunity to show you the breadth of unparalleled talents that Brock University and the Niagara region has to offer. I'm blessed and fortunate to be here tonight and lead this incredible group of players. I just would like to mention that our youngest member of the wind ensemble is Emilio Jeremiah on the piano. He also plays in my jazz ensemble. And he turned 14 yesterday, if you can believe it. He is absolutely sensational. So yes, give him a huge round of applause. Thank you very much. And thank you again for coming out and enjoy the rest of the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
gotta tell you, I was playing that and I got goosebumps. That's how amazing that was. The next piece we'll be performing for you was composed by the greatest Bohemian composer, Antonin Dvorak. And this composition in particular was arranged by Lucien Callier. Dvorak wrote this masterpiece when he resided in the United States, when he was the director of the National Conservatory of Music. He did the best to write this in the spirit of the National American Medleys, and oh boy, did he sure deliver. For your listening pleasure, please enjoy the finale from Antonin Dvorak's New World Symphony.
Thank you.
Okay. I just want to say this for all of you guys, including Zoltan. Amazing job, everybody. That has got to be the hardest piece I have ever played. I'm not joking. But it sure was rewarding. To close up the first half of our concert this evening, the Wind Ensemble has prepared a march composed by Henry Fillmore and arranged by Larry Clark. This march is a fast and fun piece that you would hear at a circus. Matter of fact, the composer himself ran out for the circus, not once, you won't believe this, not once, but twice. He ran out for the circus twice. Talk about a man of talent, eh? Now everyone, please wear your Sunday's best as we prepare to meet his honor.
Thank you.
more music lined up for this evening, so don't go anywhere. We will be right back after these commercials. Can you guys hear me? Yes? Good? Okay. All right, cool. Just wanted to make sure. All right. And we're back. Welcome back to the return of the Brock Wind Ensemble's return to live music. I said return twice there. My bad. We have some amazing pieces to play for you tonight in our second half of the show. To start things off, we will be playing you a six-part piece written by Robert Russell Bennett. These songs were produced for a 30-episode TV show for the NBC called Project 20. Each piece has its own unique sound, from waltzes to classic sea shanties imagined for the band. Robert Bennett went all out. All right, guys, make sure you have all your life jackets. Guys, all got your life jackets? Good? Up there? Life jackets? Good? Awesome. And prepare to hit the water as we go down to the sea in ships.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hope you guys didn't get seasick after that one. The next piece the Wind Ensemble will be performing this evening is composed by Philip Sparke. This piece was composed for two reasons. One was to celebrate the start of the youth band with kids aged 8 to 13 in 2004, and to salute the bicentenary of an expedition by Philip Sparke's heroes, Meriwether Lewis and William Clark. So, get your backpacks and your hiking shoes ready as we set off with the pioneers. Well then, that was quite the expedition. Our next piece is written by composer Leonard Bernstein. This song was written for a musical called Mass, which helped open the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts in 1971. This piece gives the lovely low brass section right there all its glories, as we open off with an amazing solo by Stephen on the euphonium. Chords and melodies are handed to the talented low brass players in our wind ensemble. We will also like to welcome back Emilio to the piano, as he's going to be playing the piano accompaniment to this part. Please enjoy, for listening pleasure, A Simple Song by Leonard Bernstein.
Thank you.
I would like to say congratulations to all the soloists in that piece. You guys did an amazing job. So, who's ready to get festive? Anybody? Well, I think the Performing Arts Center is. Look at that. Isn't that nice? All righty. So, our next piece is a medley. Now, in this medley, you will find Christmas standards and also some famous musical scores in there as well. Feel free to sing along as we help kick off the holidays with Christmas on Broadway, arranged by John Higgins.
Thank you.
Well, that was sure a way to start off the holidays. Oh gosh, that reminds me, I should start my Christmas shopping. Alrighty. The last piece that we have for you tonight is arranged by Philip Sparke, but it was written by one of the rock giants. It's a song that if it's played at a party, it gets everybody singing. And it was also the name of the hit movie that was released a couple years ago. Any guesses? Well, this song was off their 1975 album, A Night at the Opera, Please Enjoy, Queen's greatest hit, Bohemian Rhapsody. And one more thing, if we hear you singing along and clapping along, there's a slight chance, just a very minuscule chance, that we might have one more number. So, please enjoy the Brock Wind Ensemble performing for you, Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody.
Thank you.
amazing applause, everybody. So, as promised, we have one more number for you. All right, now grab your partner and get your cowboy hat. It is time to dance the square, partner. Yeehaw! On behalf of the Brock Wind Ensemble, we thank you for coming out and spending your Tuesday evening with us as we return to live music here at Brock University. Thank you all, drive safe, and have a wonderful evening and happy holidays. Take care.